Hi friends, welcome to my another episode on Indian history. In our previous episode, we had discussed about the famous Battle of Gorkhan. Today we will talk about the discomfiture of Shaistakhan. In spite of the repeated efforts of Adil Shah of Bijapur, he could not force Shivaji to surrender before him. Shivaji had defeated every Sardar of Bijapur. Adil Shah at last gave up the fight and he made peace with Shivaji and gave recognition to Shivaji's independent kingdom. However, there were constant Mughal attacks from the North India, which had practically ruined Maharashtra. Shivaji had now turned his attention towards the North and he carried out raids in the territory of the Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb. Aurangzeb was very angry with Shivaji and he sent Shaistakhan, his uncle, to deal with Shivaji and teach him a lesson. Shaistakhan, with a huge army of 75,000 men and hundreds of elephants, camels and pieces of cannon, marched on Pune. Pieces of cannon are the cannon balls which are thrown in the battle towards the enemy. On the way, Shaistakhan captured the towns of Shirwal, Shivapur, Saswad, and finally he laid siege to the fort of Purandar. There was nothing that could stop Shaistakhan, but once Maratha army surrounded him in a mountain pass. Maratha troops could traverse the hills and valleys in the shortest possible time on the army rations consisting of onions and bajra bread. This type of warfare perfected by the Marathas was not known to Shaistakhan. Tired of the continuous harassment by the Maratha troops, Shaistakhan removed the siege from Purandar fort. Shaistakhan then moved to the Kondana fort. First, he captured the fort of Chakan. Firangoji Narsala fought to defend the fort with great bravery and skill against the army of Shaistakhan. For 2 months, Firangoji kept Shaistakhan at bay, but he was helpless against the guns. Shaistakhan was very much impressed with the way Firangoji defended the fort for 2 months and offered him service with the Mughal Emperor. However, Firangoji refused Shaistakhan's offer. Shaistakhan then came to Pune and made Lal Mahal, Shivaji's residence, his headquarters. A year had passed, but Shaistakhan would not leave Pune. Shaistakhan's troops would raid Shivaji's territory, they destroyed his crops and they took away his cattle. In this way, he started devastating the surrounding countryside. At last, Shivaji decided to teach a lesson to Shaistakhan. It was beneficial for Shivaji that Shaistakhan was living in Lal Mahal because Shivaji knew that place inside out with all its entrance and exits, its secret doors, passages and windows. Shivaji's spies were keeping him well informed about the disposition of the Khan's troops in Lal Mahal. Shivaji therefore decided to enter Lal Mahal one night and kill Shaistakhan. Lal Mahal was very well guarded and it was difficult for Shivaji to get through 75,000 men because they were camping outside the palace. But Shivaji made up his mind and there was no one that could turn him away from his resolve. On the night of 5th April 1663, a marriage procession was passing along the streets of Pune. Hundreds of people were there in the procession. Some were in the palanquins, while many more were there on the foot. Shivaji with his band of trusted followers joined that marriage procession to give the impression that they were part of it. After some time, the procession proceeded on its way, but Shivaji and his men moved away quietly in the direction of Lal Mahal. Shivaji made a hole in the wall and entered Lal Mahal. since Shivaji knew Lal Mahal very well, it was not difficult for him to find Shaistakhan. Khan's bodyguards were half asleep. Shivaji's followers tied them up and Shivaji went in search of Shaistakhan. Shivaji went straight to the Khan's chambers and took out his sword. Terrified, the Khan started shouting, "Devil, devil," and he tried to escape through the window. Shivaji struck him with the sword, which cut off three fingers of the Khan. The Khan jumped out of the window and made for safety. To deceive Khan's troops, Shivaji and his men started shouting, "Shivaji has attacked, run, catch him," and they started to run themselves. The Khan's troops also started running in all directions. In this confusion, Shivaji and his men made their escape and reached Sihagarh. Shaistakhan's troops spent the whole night looking for Shivaji, but Shivaji had already escaped Lal Mahal. Shaistakhan was very afraid because he had just lost his fingers. He could have lost his life as well. When Aurangzeb heard about this, he was very angry with Shaistakhan and he transferred him to Bengal. This was the first serious blow to the Mughal power. Shivaji had successfully sent Shaistakhan back to Aurangzeb. So this was the chapter about the discomfort of Shaistakhan. There can be questions in the examination like, Shaistakhan laid siege to the fort of Purandar. In Pune, Shaistakhan made his headquarters in which Mahal? Lal Mahal. Aurangzeb transferred Shaistakhan to which state? Bengal. Which towns did Shaistakhan capture on the way to Pune? Shaistakhan had captured the towns of Shirwal, Shivpur, Saswad, and he finally laid siege to the fort of Purandar. What was Shaistakhan afraid that might happen? Shaistakhan was afraid that today he had lost three fingers, but Shivaji could have cut off his head as well. Give reasons. Emperor Aurangzeb was enraged and sent Shaistakhan to deal with Shivaji. Shivaji had succeeded in conquering each and every territory in Maharashtra. And this made Adil Shah give up the fight and he had made peace with Shivaji. However, Aurangzeb did not want to make a peace with Shivaji and he wanted to end his Swaraj. That is why he sent Shaistakhan to Pune to kill Shivaji. Shaistakhan tried to escape through the window. Shivaji and his men had reached Lal Mahal and it was easy for Shivaji to find Shaistakhan. Shivaji found Khan and he wanted to kill him. However, Shivaji could only attack him and he cut his three fingers off. Shaistakhan jumped out of the window and he made a way for safety. So this was the chapter regarding Shivaji's win over Shaistakhan. Do let me know your feedback on my email ID. Thank you.